Second minor diatonic descendant to the first, substitute dominant fifth of the first, in E minor is B flat. These chords, here we took one more. There is also substitute dominant for the replacement in the case of the first minor, namely the degree flat third major. That will be a D flat seventh. That is the substitute dominant fifth to the flat third in A minor. So could will be used. Then we have, we have one more, this one, substitute dominant fifth of the fourth minor. So the fourth minor is D, therefore this here has to be an E flat seventh, because it moves by second minor descendant to this. So, and here we have the 20 initial chords. Right, this here will be, for example, first minor, fifth to the flat seven, substitute, flat seven, fifth to the flat six, and then we will do substitute, fifth to the fourth. So to go to this chord, the four minor, we can use two things. Auxiliary dominant A7 or substitute fifth to the four minor. This. And here we go to the first approach, easy approach to the Andalusian cadence with 20 chords. We repeat that at the beginning. This is the history of flamenco in 3 seconds, harmonically at least. Before Paco was this, there were only four, and then now look what is there. And of course, there is other, I said it before, there are other 20 chords here, but for easy understanding, we will get first on this. Because there are several types of six, of natural six, minors of the means, etc., and also of flat six and of flat seven, and there is also natural seven, etc. This in Calle Real, there are some examples of that, and well, you know, many falsettos have this material and beyond, because it is around 40 chords. So from 4 to 40, that was the the change that Paco brought to this music. Now, one important thing is we need to create melodies with this and create art and beauty. We need to explore it properly. It's not enough to just know it. And just as Bill McBurney said very wisely, that in theory, there is no difference between practice and theory. But in practice, there is. Because when we need to do things, there will be a gap. And this gap should be eliminated through proper study. So therefore, proper study means personalized study. Let's repeat one more time that you cannot learn this really well just by watching videos. It's not possible, because the way you will take the material and use it is only personal to you. And therefore, the expert teacher should be able to find out what is the best way and at what level in a given moment you can start from to create stuff with this. So we have a whole study program with all these materials ready for you, so you are very welcome to join the Skype lessons, and then I can explain you this personally and tell you how you can start factually to play with these beautiful possibilities and get all the juice out of this extension that Paco, you know, he reinvented flamenco this way, because it became very rich. And here we have the 20 chords, which of course replacing chords and these things, that's why I said this is a matter of personal training, because in the very same music, you start with one fragment of music, or like this falsetta, which Leal from the Tirocore was playing. Substitute fifth of flat seven to the fifth minor. So, so you can do unlimited things with this. So I hope this will be useful to inspire you to get more knowledge about, because this is the important thing to learn, and the real value. That's repeat it one more time, because this is a super important point. The real value of learning falsettas is to learn by analysis, not to learn the falsetta and just parrot it over and over, but to know what this is made of and how I can create different variations. Then we will, once this is handled in every key, then we will also go to the extended chart, to the other 20 chords. Like, example, like what? Well, there is this falsetto, for example, which has a minor, this here, I think, yeah, this here has a minor seventh. This is one. It was Gloria and Emilio Ricardo Soler. This is a G minor in place of that. So there are more than this. It's not just G major, it exists also in other ways. What is that? C major, flat third, major, major seventh. Visualize all the family in one shot, as soon as you say any key, G minor, okay, I know all these guys what they're doing, and then also eventually ways to play melodies over these chords. that will not happen alone. Some people think that, yeah, we need to marry, but then they don't do anything about it, and then like hoping that when you need it, it will land from somewhere. No, it will not happen. You need to approach the subject and approach it properly at the way you can actually grasp it. And then you can use it really, because this is the language of flamenco, right? This is the language of flamenco. It's not just a paper there, but it's a language. This is the real language of it. I can memorize a poem in Chinese, and then in a Chinese party I can go and recite the poem. Yeah, but I don't know what I am saying. Actually, I don't know the grammatical construction, the cases, the verbs, nothing, present, past, I don't know, present tense, I don't know. I just repeat parroting over something. Maybe the pronunciation is right. And guess what? This is what most people do with guitar. Repeating things like a parrot. The traditional lessons of guitar, which are, everyone teaches this way. We don't do it. I see it all over. These people come to me and tell me this. How they teach. The guy sits there and they say, now repeat this, and they parrot over and over, and that's all. But they never understood why it is done. So this is the why. Here is the whole chart of ingredients to create the food and the meals are created from, the recipe is created from these ingredients here. So therefore it corresponds to the teacher to indicate these points and based on the Paco de Lucía discography, explain what to do. And then that is the real value of playing falsettos. Then you can really enjoy playing it because then now you really know how that was made. And then of course it means that you also will know how you can make other falsettos or other combinations using the same principles. So thank you very much and I see you next time.
Me ayudó lo que descubrí ahí en la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música debería aprender, porque en la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando, de cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Pablo, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.